Pat Buttram, The Rocking Chair Humorist by Sandra Grabman. Introduction. Pat Buttram has been the source of laughter and joy to me since I was a child in the 1950s. The tension caused by Gene Autry's pursuit of the bad guys on his television program was broken by his yodely voice sidekick, Pat, who had the wonderful ability of turning our frowns into smiles. During my teen years, Pat reappeared on television, this time as a regular on the delightful comedy Green Acres. Again, we'd begin laughing when he made his entrance each week because we knew his character, Mr. Haney, would do his level best to con Mr. Douglas out of a few bucks. He was usually successful, too. What was Pat Buttram really like, I wondered? Was he the typical comedian who is the embodiment of merriment on stage but glum when the cameras weren't rolling? Were all his hilarious lines written for him, or did he think funny? Wanting to get to the bottom of this, I went to his family, friends, and cronies in showbiz and asked them to share their memories with me. What they taught me about Pat Buttram reaffirmed my conviction that I have excellent taste in men. Pat was even funnier offstage. He wrote not only much of his own material, but that of some of his friends as well. Would you believe President Reagan? Yep, Pat gifted him with some nifty one-liners that were delivered with a merry sparkle in our president's eyes. As Robert Benchley told Pat, he was not a comedian. Rather, he was a humorist. There is a distinct difference, and Benchley recognized Buttram's talent for what it was. Pat was a very good man who loved to make people happy. He had a soft heart for charities as well and lent his talents to their success. In looking back at his life, I get the feeling that it was meant to be. Pat was born to bring us laughter and happiness. Things fell so neatly into place in his career that a divine hand just had to be involved. My purpose in writing this book was not only to tell you the life story of this brilliant man, but also to bring a smile to your face. Throughout the book, I have included many of Pat's jokes for your enjoyment. These jokes are read by Pat's nephew, John Buttram. If they make you laugh, my goal will be achieved. Chapter 1. The date was June 19, 1915. The place was Addison, Alabama, population 200. On the little back porch of the rural parsonage, 4-year-old Hallie Buttram was frightened. Something scary seemed to be going on inside the house, and she and her 2-year-old brother Gus had been sent outside. Their older siblings, Peggy, Mamie, Johnny, and Corey, were elsewhere. Now, 9 decades later, the events of that night make much more sense to Hallie. Their baby brother, Maxwell Emmett Buttram, was being born. Someday, the world would know him as Pat, but that nickname would come later in his childhood. Both of little Maxwell's given names had been surnames of his ancestors. The house in which big brother Gus was born in 1913 had originally been a saloon, but was converted into a Methodist parsonage, and the house in which Maxwell was born had originally been a church before its conversion. Thus, it became a family joke that Gus, who would someday become a minister, was born in a saloon, while Maxwell, who would someday perform in establishments that served alcohol, was the one born in the church. Their father, Wilson McDaniel, Mac, Buttram, had something in common with his new son right away. Each was the 7th child in his family. Mac had first met his wife, Mary Emmett Maxwell, when her mother was his Sunday school teacher at Mount Hope. They were married in 1901 at Maxwell Chapel, the church near Haleyville that had been built with her family's own hands. As the family breadwinner, Mac had first been a farmer and mule trader, but then became a licensed circuit-riding Methodist minister in 1912, the third generation in his family to pursue a career in the ministry. He was appointed to the Addison Circuit and would serve six churches, which were situated in mining communities. These were very small churches.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.